What's up, sons? It's Blind Rod with Summit Tech once again. Today, I wanted to bring you a review of the MSI Mag B550 Tomahawk motherboard. So they've added this whole branding of Mag to a lot of their products. And what that leans towards, at least in my experience, has been their higher frame rate performance gaming. So another product that's really popular right now that you should check out would be the Mag 251. It's a monitor from MSI that has a fast IPS panel and a 240 hertz refresh rate. And this motherboard here would be a great option as well for pairing with that monitor, and there's a lot of good features, and we're going to go over them right now. All right, so first of all, this motherboard is going to be a full ATX as far as form factor, so you're going to be looking at cases that will support that, of course. It's not going to be a mini or a micro, so make sure you check the case specifications and confirm that this motherboard will fit in there. Going on from there, it does support DDR4 memory up to 128 gigabytes and up to a 5100 megahertz overclock. So if you can find some memory out there with a DOCP profile of 5100 megahertz, you should be good to go. Of course, for overclockers and all that, I don't think they would be looking at this particular motherboard, but if they were, you know, you can probably get above that. All right, so we're going to just rattle off the rest of the specifications, starting off with the PCIe slots. You have quite a few here. You have two PCIe 4.0 slots by 16. They will support prior generations of PCI Express, so don't worry about that. You have two PCI by one slots, and that's for any additional add-in cards that you may have. A perfect example would be an Elgato capture card, and this motherboard would be great, of course, with as a streaming rig, so keep that in mind as well. You have six SATA 3 ports. This is kind of going the way of the dinosaur. I do understand that a lot of people want to use SATA still, and there are devices that you want to plug up in that manner. That being said, six seems a little bit extensive, but of course having more is never a bad thing. I don't know. I don't see a reason for using six, especially because this motherboard only supports RAID 1, RAID 0, and RAID 10. So it's not like it has an onboard RAID controller where you're going to be setting up some sort of a storage system, a SAN or a network attached storage or anything like that. Since you aren't going to be doing that with this system because of the limitation on the RAID, of course, unless you did a PCI Express slot to handle your RAID for a RAID controller, I'm not quite certain that you really need all six SATA 3s. You have two M.2 slots. Glad to see that. They both support PCIe 4.0, which is also another awesome feature, part of up to about 6,000 megabytes per second. And then probably around the same for read and write, and it's super fast. I've been running the Sabrent Rocket 4.0 and I've been super happy with it. So if you haven't checked out that as an option, I highly recommend, because the price isn't that much different than a PCIe 3.0 card. If you're going to be purchasing a motherboard that already supports it, definitely pick up like the Sabrent Rocket 1 terabyte drive for under $200. And they are blazing fast. You're gonna have fast load times. For single player games, it's definitely a lot more obvious. Highly recommended, and a great feature to see on this motherboard, and something Intel doesn't have, so keep that in mind. Now you have two NICs, which is another feature of this motherboard that not a lot of, I guess, mid-range to low-range motherboards have. They did go away from using or having any Wi-Fi support on this particular motherboard. But having two NICs is pretty awesome. You have a 1 gig NIC and a 2.5 gig NIC. So you do have the slightly faster option as well there, already built in, ready for you to go ahead and hook up. And nothing bad to say about that. Super awesome to see that. USB headers. All right. So all the headers that are going to support any USB connections outside of the case, for example, on your front panel. Or of course, if you're using something like a all-in-one cooler from NZXT or Corsair where you need to plug into a USB 2.0 header, that's important to note how many you have for that as well. So you have one USB 3.2 Type-C port header for, you know, probably the front panel. You have two USB 3.2 Type-A ports, and that's going to be basically supporting, you know, it's a thin little strip and it's the 3.0. So you're going to have that support there. You got four USB 2.0 Type A ports. I don't know that you would ever run out or need more than four. You're going to have plenty of USB 2.0 headers for all of your various devices, like we stated, maybe an all-in-one cooler, maybe Corsair IQ. There's plenty of different options out there in devices that require having them, so I think they're still needed on a motherboard. And having this many on the motherboard means you're not going to run out of them if you have multiple devices that utilize this. Now, for the USB ports that are built into the motherboard, and they're going to be on the rear, you have one USB 3.2 Type-C port, three USB 3.2 Type-A ports, and two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. You also have an optical out for audio, and it's, you know, pretty standard stuff as far as all that goes. Your display ports, the caveat here is going to be that if you want to run any display off of the motherboard itself, you'll have to have a supporting CPU that has integrated graphics. So you're talking about like the 2200G, 2400G, 3200G, and 3400G. If you have one of those, this motherboard will support that, and you can just go ahead and get it hooked up and it'll function. It has one HDMI slot on the motherboard and one DisplayPort slot on the motherboard. So that also supports HDMI 2.0, and you're going to be able to support FreeSync off of that if you're running the AMD integrated GPUs. So good to note as far as all that goes. Finally, let's go over all of the internal connectors. There's a ton of stuff going on here. You have one 8-pin CPU power. That's important to note because some motherboards will have additional CPU power, and that's going to be important for either higher end CPUs like Ryzen 9 stuff. Although this will support Ryzen 9 for overclocking and getting higher clocks out of Ryzen 9, you may want to go look at the X570 motherboards. I would think that pretty much like Ryzen 7 and below is really what you're going to want to be looking at for this motherboard. Not that you can't run Ryzen 9, like I said, it's supported, you're just not going to get the full power out of it, so I'd probably start leaning towards X570 at that point. You have 8 4-pin fan headers, and they are labeled, so you have 6 for the case fans, and then you have 1 for the CPU fan, and 1 for the water pump if you're running a water pump, and those notations on those fan headers are just going to help you navigate your BIOS as well as any monitoring software that you have going along with this. Now, you have one front panel audio connector, two system panel connectors, one chassis intrusion connector in case you need that, two 4-pin RGB LED connectors, and two 3-pin rainbow LED connectors. So sometimes those are called like ARGB. So if you're looking at any ARGB devices, you want to keep that in mind and never get those mixed up. Now, you usually wouldn't mix them up if it's a 3-pin trying to go into a 4-pin because it won't fit. But I've seen plenty of cases, and I've even done it myself, where I've plugged a 4-pin into a 3-pin, blew all the LEDs out in my system, and just cried in the corner. So keep that in mind when you are putting together your system, that you understand which lighting system you're going with and where it needs to plug up into. So other than that, you have one TPM module connector, and that wraps up all of the features on the motherboard. This is a very feature-rich motherboard for a B550, and I would say it would be a great budget motherboard if we were seeing any sort of retail costs on any of these. And the fact is, we don't have that. We have a very odd market and economy going on right now, especially with as far as when I spoke with a rep from MSI, I was told that essentially they're only shipping like via air, so no boats are coming in. I was actually talking to them about getting a monitor, still can't find one. They're apparently only getting a couple hundred in maybe a month, and now it seems like even less than that. And that's all on plane, and they're sold out before, you know, they pretty much land here. That's going to be the same with for a lot of electronic components. So if you're looking at a review and this motherboard is up for sale and it's at retail or even close to retail, just go ahead and buy it. It's a good motherboard. It's been running strong. It support, you know, the PBO worked great out of the box. It had great system monitoring. it's MSI, you know, it's there, it works well. And to be honest, this is the most features I've ever seen out of B series motherboard, period. I haven't even checked out any of the other B550 motherboards from Asus or ASRock or anything like that. But I can tell you from my experience with B450 and B350 that this just wipes the table with them. It's night and day, completely superior in every way. There's no reason that you should avoid buying this motherboard if you can actually find one. So, you know, go ahead and pick it up. Let me know what motherboards you're finding too, and how much you're getting them for. It's just weird. The pricing's weird. Everything's weird right now. I'll have a link to this one down in the description. Hopefully it's in stock at Amazon. You can buy it with my affiliate link. That'd be cool. If you enjoyed the review, you know what to do. Leave that like, hit that notification bell, and hit that subscribe, and share this thing out. Until next time, I will see you next Tuesday. That's a lot of next. Peace.